Very interesting, significant table. Many wells. So let us see what you have in the center. You have in the center Shnat Taf Shin Pei, the year 5780. But in fact, there is continuation. Continuation is Aleph. So basically, it is Taf Shin Pei Aleph. Only because of the area, small bound, so it did not come out. But basically, there is a continuation to it. As I said, it's a continuation. And it tells us 5781. So in this one, you see only 5780, but in fact, it is 5781. So what you have in the table, which makes it very significant and interesting, the first thing really is, well, this was I looking for. I looked for the year 5781 with the end of days, Achrit Hayamim, exactly come here the verse in the end of days, because 7071 is considered end of days, as we saw in many other places. Then definitely I wanted to see if Messiah is here. So Messiah comes here. You can see Messiah, in fact, Messiah of my people. In fact, there are three times Messiah. Messiah, and Messiah. Now, what are the three? So we know quite well. The first one is the son of Joseph will pave the way of the son of Jesse. Son of Jesse, son of David. And the third one is Cyrus, yeah, Koresh. Cyrus, in the past, it was Cyrus who is called Messiah of God by Isaiah because he was helping Israel to get back to their land, to settle, to do what God wanted them to do. This is why it's called the Messiah of God. Amazing. Today we have Donald Trump who recognized Jerusalem, recognized the Bible, the prophecies. So the same thing, Kabbalah says, also you have spots of Cyrus. So amazingly, so you have your Cyrus, your end of days, Messiah, the Messiah, even is the Messiah. If he's the Messiah, the son of Jesse, Messiah, son of Joseph, Donald Trump. Definitely helping Israel to settle, fighting with the leftists, with the Democrats, with against the Torah. They allow laws which are against the Torah, homosexuality, abortion, one man. Marriage definitely is against the Torah. So what we have more here, definitely we have Joseph, as we said, Messiah of Joseph. Then we have definitely the most important names here. So who are those names? Who are these people? We know Elijah. Elijah will come with the Messiah. Definitely, yeah. But who are the other names? So our rabbis tell us that the Messiahs have four names. One is Menachem, one is Inon, one is Hanina, and one is Shiloh, which comes many times here. So, what is the idea? What are four Messiahs? I mean, they're not. But each name has meaning in Hebrew, like Menachem. Comfort him. He will comfort Israel. Inon means ruling. He will rule. Melech HaMashiach. Then Hanina, which you have here, Hanina, is from having mercy. Yeah, we'll have mercy. Shiloh, which doesn't come clearly because there are so many of them. So means Shiloh. Our rabbis tell us in future, the world will recognize the greatness of Israel, of Jews, and they give presents. Not today, we see already. He'll be the Amorite, right? And then what you have here in its time, definitely when we speak about the 5781 is in its time. Now you have also your the images of Purim, because it's the same thing, our rabbis tell us, similar to the time of Purim, when we had Esther, we had Mordechai, comes also here, in fact. And Cyrus, and they really brought the great victory of Jews over their enemies, Amalekite, Iran. That was Persia, but today is Iran. We have you also Milchama Ba'asachem, we will be a war in your town, which is in Israel, in your land, which is similar to what we had in the time of Purim and also in the time of Hanukkah. And we have also Hanukkah, Matityahu. Matityahu is Zazmanian from Hanukkah time. Now, our rabbi said that the war of Gog Magog, which comes here, a war in your land, is be similar to the war that Jews had with the Greeks at that time, the enemies. Why? Because at that time, the land, the war was in the land in Israel, like today. We have Ashraf, Patach, you have Hezbollah, you have Iran, all of them tried to be here, yeah? And then what we have more, we had spiritual war. We have Lapid, Lieberman, people who are leftist, Meretz, who are fighting the Torah spiritually, exactly like in the time of Hanukkah. It was physical, but also spiritual. The Greeks, like today, wanted to abolish the Sabbath, purity of life, and exactly what today the leftists are doing, and what the Democrats really basically the same idea. So, this is exactly why Matityahu comes here, remind us. So, hoping that really we'll do repentance, we have your repentance definitely, also, which is important, which is really the condition for redemption. And this is what we have here. Elijah will come. And as we said, Esther coming and Esther from Purim, this is a connection definitely. And the most important, as we said, is the end of days, Messiah. And in its time, we said many times, and as I said many times, parallel are very significant. It's a parallel, parallel. And once in the Torah. Now, as I said, the continuation of this table that you saw, end of days and so on, the same thing. In the 5-7 we have additional interesting thing. We have, when we talk about the war in our land, what is the threat today from Iran? Iran coming, you see, in black, in red, Iran, amazing. So, very interesting and very significant table, an important one, as we said, as the Torah is a blueprint of creation, and everything which is going on in the Torah. So therefore, keeping the Torah, this is what really we have to do. And in fact, there is a verse here, this is the most important, the verse, we say Samor et Yom HaShabbat. Remember the Sabbath to sanctify it like God commanded you. This is from the Ten Commandments. What you see here is the Ten Commandments. And then he said, afterwards also, the same idea, Sheshet Yamim Tavot, 6 days you should work, and you should do your work. Uvayom Shashvi, or the seventh day, Shabbat, Sabbath, to your God, don't do any work. And anybody who does, heavenly death. So amazingly, which is the basis of repentance, the Sabbath. Our rabbis tell us that the merit of Sabbath, you will have Israel. And if you don't keep Sabbath, your enemies will come. The Amalekites, which today are the Iranians, Hezbollah, Patach, Ashraf, all those who are against Israel. So interesting and significant table for our time.